Fedora 42 is here, sleek, polished, and packed with improvements that refine the Linux desktop experience. From the installer to distro Wellbeing tools, this release is packed with thoughtful updates. Let's take a tour of the visual highlights of Fedora 42 in this video. After 25 long years, Fedora is replacing the Anaconda installer with the Anaconda Web UI installer. No more GTK, the new interface is based on the same tech that powers Red Hat's Cockpit project. If you didn't know already, Cockpit is a web-based server management tool. You'll notice changes here and there, like this rescan devices option. The biggest change here is the new guided partitioning function that gives you plenty of customization options. There are improved support for dual boot configurations along with a new reinstall Fedora option. I recorded this video in a VM, so I cannot show you all the options it would have on a bare metal system. The rest of the installer is all the same. By the way, did you notice it didn't ask to create any user password for the system? We shall see it in the next section. At the first login after the installation, Fedora once again gives you the option to select or change the locales, handle the telemetry, time zone selection, and option to enable some third-party repositories. And finally, you get to create the user. Could it not have been done during the installation, like Ubuntu? I don't know. Anyways, the GNOME welcome screen starts now, which is like the in-flight safety demonstration. Frequent GNOME users are just going to ignore them by clicking the next option. The desktop is typical GNOME and nothing has changed in the UI. There are new visual features in GNOME 48 that I'll discuss later, of course. For some supported models, you may see an option to set the battery charging limit. Unfortunately, it wasn't available in my case, even on a bare metal system with CacheOS and Ubuntu. There is also revamped color management option for those who are specific about the color profile of their display, which I am not. By the way, did you notice these numbers on the tree here? 42 is the Fedora version, sure. But how come 6 into 9 equals 42? How come 42 is the answer? Can you guess, hitchhiker? Or will you just panic and throw in the towel? Answer in the comments. The most important feature introduced in GNOME 48 and thus Fedora 42 is the distal well-being. Like your smartphone, you can see screen time uses and set a time limit after which the screen turns gray to discourage you from using your computer. And then there are eyesight reminders to look away from the screen for a few seconds. I like this feature the most. There are also movement reminders to leave the chair every 30 minutes or so. These are reminders, so you can ignore them at times, but the more strictly you follow them, better it will be for your health. Before we move further, let me thank our sponsor,
Warp Terminal. Warp is a modern, Rust-based terminal app with built-in AI agent to help you boost productivity as a dev or DevOps with a modern IDE-like user experience. You can use ChatGPT or DeepSeek in it. It can also be integrated with VS Code. Link to try Warp is in the description.
A small change is in the message tree. Now multiple notifications from the same applications are grouped together. This gives you a cleaner notification area and easier way to follow the messages. The calendar app has new design improvements being put in place for the event editor dialog, which now features a new all day time slot section and the option to select time zones for start and end times for the events. easy viewing of weather information in the month view. So subtle changes in GNOME calendar if you use it. FlatHub website is an excellent place for discovering new Flatpak applications. While it gives you an option to install the application of your choice, all it does is to download a Flatpakref file. Earlier, you could only use the terminal and run the flat commands to install the software from the Flatpakref file. But now, you can open it in the software center, in the GNOME software center, with double click and install it from the comfort of the graphical interface. Speaking of comfort of GUI, you can manage all the system updates from the software center. That is not something new. Just wanted to let you know that you won't miss Windows much here in Fedora 42. There are under the hood changes as well to give you improved performance. This video was entirely focused on GNOME as that is the default desktop choice. KDE lovers can get excited as KDE Plasma is now an addition, not just a spin. And at the same time, Fedora Cosmic Spin is getting popular as well. If you are already using Fedora 40 or 41, you can upgrade to Fedora 42 from within your system. For others, you have to do a fresh install. It's your turn now. Between Ubuntu 25.04 and Fedora 42, who has better implementation of GNOME 48? I'll let you comment while I work on the next video. Stay subscribed. Bye-bye.